Well, good morning, everyone. Welcome. So good to see you. Great to, for all of us to be together here this morning for this very, very special chapel. And I know that we're going to see many of you tonight for our wonderful Christmas concert, 7 o'clock. So we look forward to that, followed by a very special art show afterwards, art presentation, art gallery, so that many of our students, many of our lower school students have participated in. So that's all tonight. Now, I think it'd be safe to say that we're all looking forward to Christmas break. I think that's a pretty safe assumption. But I want to tell you something that you can look forward to when you come back. Some of you remember that last year, we had our first ever service learning week. And it was a fantastic week. We loved it. And we're going to do it again this year. And we're going to spend the first few minutes of this chapel dedicating all of us, because every one of us is going to be involved in serving in some capacity, every one of us in this room. So we want to dedicate that time to the Lord, and we're going to do that here in the next couple of minutes. Let me just say that why do we do something like Service Learning Week? You know, it's been said that we are the most like Jesus when we serve others. Jesus himself came not to be served, but to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many, to give his life for us. And so when we serve, we're being like Jesus. But also, there's something else. Jesus also said that it's more blessed to give than to receive. And he said that whoever wants to save their lives will lose their lives, but whoever will lose their lives for my sake and the gospel will find it. And then he went on to say later that no one has left father, mother, brother, sister, homes, lands, for my sake and the gospel, that will not receive a hundredfold in this life and eternal life in the life to come. Here's the point, that when we serve, we're being like Jesus, but when we serve, there is great blessing, there's great joy that comes back to us. And many of you have experienced that in this room, and by God's grace, we're going to experience it again the first week when we come back from our Christmas break. So what we want to do now is to dedicate ourselves to the Lord and that he would use this service for his great glory. So let me tell you how we're going to do this. We're going to dedicate by schools. So we're going to first have the lower school. And what I'd like for you to do is I'd like to have you stand, all of our lower school students and also our lower school teachers. And I'm going to ask Mr. Schroeder to come up, and he's going to pray. And let me just tell you some of the things that you're going to be doing. This is just a small sample of some of the kinds of opportunities that our lower school students are going to have. There's going to be the opportunity to visit the Holy Spirit Missionary Sisters, our dear friends that are right behind us, and to serve them. There's also an opportunity to work with Berean Ministries, which you'll hear more about. There's opportunity to make some blankets to give to friends. There's an opportunity to make some special projects to minister to military families. And there's also going to be the opportunity for some of our lower school students to work with Feed My Starving Children. And those are just some of the opportunities that you're going to have that first week in January when we come back. So Mr. Schroeder is going to come and pray for you, for us, as we dedicate this time to him.
Please join with me in prayer. Father, we thank you for the gift of your Son. We thank you for the opportunity to serve others. Help us to remember that you have commanded us to go the extra mile. Help us and bless our service learning week. May service become part of our everyday life. In your name, amen.
You may be seated. Now, let me tell you what the middle school students are going to do. They're going to work with a ministry called Exodus World Service, which is a very interesting simulation of what it's like to immigrate into this country. I don't have time to explain it fully. You're going to have the opportunity to visit with our friends at Divine Word Ministries down the road. There's going to be opportunity to care for some Guatemalan girls through a ministry called El Faro. There's also the opportunity to work with Lydia Home. Some of you are familiar with Lydia Home, which is a home to a ministry to orphans and to single mothers. There's the opportunity to work with Timothy Ministry, which is a ministry to the homeless, and also Kindred Life Ministry, which works with young teen moms. And again, just some of the kinds of things that you middle school students will have the opportunity to do that first week when we come back. I'd like to ask Mr. Chavez to come up, and I'd like to ask all the middle school students and teachers to stand, and Mr. Chavez is going to come and pray and dedicate you and this time to the Lord.
Please bow your heads with me. Heavenly Father, Lord, I do thank you for each of these young men and women here at CHA, especially the middle schoolers. And Lord, as we travel about, Lord, bring us there safely, bring us back not only just full of the fun or the ways and stories that we served you, Lord, but bring us back with a greater sense of your role and your spirit and the power that you bring to how we serve. Lord, I pray that you open each of their hearts and our hearts, the faculty members' hearts, of ways that we can more fully serve you, more fully rely on you as we serve. Open our hearts. Allow us to fully embrace your will for our lives here at CHA. In your son's name, amen.
Thank you. You may be seated. And now our upper school students, we actually have some wonderful, wonderful ministry trips. And a little bit different in the upper school, the entire week, they will be working with each of these different ministries or organizations. So let me just list them for you. Pacific Garden Mission in Chicago, Center for Enriched Living, which is here locally. The Willow Creek Care Center, Wells of Mercy. And then so those are four different sites in the Chicagoland area. And then we have two teams that are going to be going overseas, one to the Dominican Republic and one to France. And so we want you to hear a little bit about each of these trips very, very quickly, these different opportunities. And so first, Mr. Chung is going to come and tell us about Pacific Garden Mission as the Pacific Garden Mission team comes up. So please come up, Pacific Garden Mission team, as Mr. Chung comes up to tell us about the organization.
Hello, so there's about 28 of us going to Pacific Garden Missions, and what we'll do there is we'll be serving there by making the beds, by cooking, and you know that's for the homeless ministry that they have, and it's going to be a great opportunity for us to just partner with them for the week, and we're all excited. And we had a meeting last week, a couple days ago, just talking about and praying for our time there. And so if you could join us. Yeah.
Great. Please stay up here. Thank you, Mr. Chung. A tremendous ministry at Pacific Garden Mission. And last year it was a wonderful, wonderful opportunity. Okay, I'd like to have Mrs. Yu come up, and she's going to tell us about the Center for Enriched Living and also the Center for Enriched Living team. Please come up. Yeah, you guys stay. Just kind of slide back a little bit.
Good morning, CHA family. This is our Center for Enriched Living team. And Center for Enriched Living is actually a community center that serves adults and young adults with severe mental and physical disabilities. How many of you guys, how do you feel loved? When you guys make a new friend, how many of you guys feel loved when you make a new friend? Yeah, what do you do with that new friend? Do you play with them? Do you play games? Do you talk to them about life and ask questions and get to know them? Sometimes, how many of you guys have ever had a play date where you cook with them? Do you ever cook? Have a cooking play date? Well, that's what we're going to do. We're going to be friends. That week at Center Enriched Learning and Living, this is our team, and we're going to be cooking, playing games, playing board games, being in the gym, and getting to know them and making good friends. Last year, Lizzie Marr was on our team, and she, in fact, went back in the summer to volunteer there. And by the end of that week, let me just tell you, we had few people, the people who, in the community center, they were asking for Lizzie by name. They were like, where is Lizzie? Where's my new friend? And so we're super excited to go and make some new friends that week.
Good. Thank you so much, Ms. Yu. Fantastic. We're going to have great ministry there at the Center for Enriched Living. Now I'd like to ask Coach Cook to come up and also the Willow Creek Care Center team. Coach Cook is returning to lead our Willow Creek Care Center team. Coach?
So last year was our first year over there, and we, the team, did a great job, and they actually didn't want us to stop coming over even last year. But we have a new group this year, and what we do over at Willow Creek in Barrington is we work in the care center providing help with bagging groceries, taking groceries out to the people who come in, to take it out to their cars, sorting through clothes, just helping people that are a little underprivileged, and helping make their week a little bit better.
Great, thank you so much. Now I'd like to have Mrs. Skutnikoff come up, please. And she's gonna tell us about the Well of Mercy ministry and the Well of Mercy team, please come up.
Good morning. So this is our Well of Mercy team, and it's about 12 ladies. It will be going to Chicago, and the Well of Mercy is an opportunity to come alongside single mothers that have come from various difficult backgrounds, and helping them by taking care of their children while they go and get a college degree possibly, and to make steps towards a brighter future for their families. So we're really excited to go there and be able to take care of their children, up to 10 babies and maybe 10 school-age children and younger. And so we're excited to play with them and to also help them with whatever they would have us do, as well as just pray, a lot of prayer for that ministry.
Another great opportunity to serve. Now, as I mentioned, we have two teams that are going overseas. I'd like to ask the Dominican Republic team to please come up, and that will be led by Mr. Bishop and some of our other faculty. Mr. Bishop will share a little bit about the DR trip.
Good morning, parents, guests, and especially students. Yeah, this trip is going to the Dominican Republic, which, if you guys don't know, that is an island in the Caribbean. And what we'll be doing is we'll be visiting a school just like ours in some ways, but the school is also an orphanage. So a lot of the students live at the school because they don't have a home to go to. So we'll be not only helping build or paint or do work projects at the school for the students, but we'll also be spending a lot of time playing with the kids and just trying to love them well and help the teachers with anything they need. And we'll be doing this with an organization called Kids Alive International, who we've had the privilege of working with for many years now at CHA.
Great, thank you so much. And we're glad to be able to go back to the DR and have the opportunity to serve our friends there again. One other trip, and this is a new trip for us this year, I'd like to have Mrs. Collins and the France team come up. A tremendous opportunity to serve in France this year. Mrs. Collins is going to tell us about that.
All right, so this is our France team. There's 15 of us that are going this year, and we are going to Lyon, France, which is where a family that has been with us for 2 years here at CHA, the Ducrozet family, now lives, and they are missionaries over there. And so we are going to serve with them and work alongside them. They work with the CREW ministry, so we'll be working with college kids as well as a homeless ministry and helping them in their church and anywhere they need us. And we're really going to be learning a lot about what God is doing in the church in France, because France is not a very churched country at this point, and so it's really going to be an educational trip for us to learn a lot about what God's doing in Europe and see how we can serve. So we're really excited about it. Please join us in praying.
Thank you so much. Just think of the potential impact that these students, and Lord willing, will have as they go and serve in these various places. But as I said earlier, the thing that most excites me is what God's going to do in their hearts and lives. To pray, we have a very special guest and friend of CHA to come and pray. Some of you, most of you know that Dr. Roth served as the leader of our school for many, many years, but he also started our upper school. And how appropriate that Dr. Roth would come and pray and commit these students and these teams to the Lord. Thank you, Dr. Roth.
It was much easier in 2009 to present the upper school. There were 12 students. Please bow with me as I pray. Dear Jesus, Service Learning Week is when mission teams, classrooms, and student teams serve and do projects, both traveling internationally, locally, and in their classrooms, for others in your name and for your glory. We ask for a hedge of protection around all the CHA community as we love and serve others, as you have modeled and commanded us. Keep everyone safe. We dedicate every activity and every conversation during CHA Service Learning Week into your hands and for your glory alone. In Jesus' name, amen.
Welcome to chapel, everyone. We will start with a prayer. Okay, we will pray to us for today.
God, thank you for this day. Please make. Thank you for chapel, and thank you for family and friends. I love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Matthew 1:23.
Open your Bibles to Matthew 1:23.
Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel. Matthew 1:23.
Please stand and join us in worship.
Jesus, every breath I take, I breathe in you.
they told me ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. A newborn king to see ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring ba-rum-ba-bum-bum.
Please remain seated, but join us in singing Silent Night.
Bye. Look, everyone.
The angels appear to the shepherds.
From to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord.
Ooh, look, guys, what's that bright light?
I'm afraid.
The shepherds obeyed right away and went to worship baby Jesus.
Jesus was born in the small town of Bethlehem, like the Bible said.
Where does it say that in the Bible?
Luke 2 says you will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger.
Let's go worship the king. Come on, guys, let's go.
Baby's about to be born.
Oh, really?
Joseph, say, let's go. Joseph,
we'll just take the stable.
Meanwhile, in the east, the wise men saw a huge star.
They studied and studied and knew it was a very special star.
They decided to follow the big gigantic star.
The huge star led the wise men to baby Jesus.
Look, there's a big star.
Let's follow the big star.
Prepared to worship the king.
They knelt before baby Jesus and presented the gifts.
Jesus, I brought you gold.
What?
Jesus, I brought you myrrh.
Jesus, I brought you incense.
We're going to sing Merry Happy Birthday, Jesus. Can you please join us as you're sitting down on your seat?
Jesus died on the cross for our sins.
Jesus is my Savior.
Jesus washed away our sins.
Jesus is my rock and my Redeemer.
Jesus has a kind heart.
Jesus is my Messiah.
Jesus gave me foodie.
Jesus took away my sins.
Jesus is love.
Jesus is wonderful.
Jesus, he loves me so much.
Jesus is my king.
Jesus is amazing.
Jesus, my mommy and daddy.
Jesus saved me.
Jesus is strong.
Jesus is mighty.
Jesus gave beautiful hearts.
Jesus is mighty.
Jesus is a beautiful song.
Jesus is my best friend.
Jesus loves us.
Jesus is powerful.
Jesus is the Savior.
Jesus listens to my prayers.
Jesus died for me.
Jesus never sins.
Jesus gave me his heart.
Jesus is happy.
Happy birthday, Jesus. Yeah, amen. I don't know about you, but after hearing those little ones sing happy birthday, Jesus, I just really have tears in my eyes, really. I love that. This chapel today, I know we're running a little long, but I have to say this. This chapel today, students, parents, guests, this chapel today is exactly what our school is about. Every one of you guys going out on those mission trips and every one of you guys staying here, you were once in this kindergarten class doing this play or at your church doing a play too. You guys were here. I love that. We start with the very youngest and ground them in who Jesus is and what the Bible says. And then we grow them up, train them up alongside you and your church, and then we send them out. I'm so thankful today we got to do the dedication for you guys on the very same day that the kindergartners got to do the chapel. It is just such a beautiful picture of the life that we have in Christ from beginning to where you are now and then on into eternity. So let me pray. Happy birthday, Jesus. Thank you so much that you came once as a mild servant, and thank you that you are even now praying on our behalf and sending us out. Thank you that we can train up the little ones, the elementary, the middle school, and the high school to know who you are and to know that you are servant. You were servant of all, and now you send us out as servants. Lord, thank you, though, that you are coming again in might and power as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And everyone will bow, every knee will bend to your lordship. We thank you. Thank you for that. Lord God, I pray you would bless everyone in this audience and help them to just ruminate and think about the things that they heard today, they saw today, and continue to pray for our teams going out. We thank you, Jesus, because everything we need and want and have is in you. Amen. All right, well today, I usually just say the fifth graders, you get to go first, but sorry, fifth graders, it's not your turn today. Upper school, I'm going to have you guys show the lower school how you can go out in a fashionably manner. So upper school, go ahead and you be dismissed first. Lower school and middle school, double check to make sure you got your Bibles if you brought them. Middle school, I'll go ahead and dismiss. If there are middle school students, you guys may be dismissed as well. I need a picture of that. Fifth graders, you may be dismissed. Fourth graders, get ready. Check for your Bibles because you're going to go next. Kindergarten parents, you're welcome to come up and greet your students and begin taking pictures and videos. Weren't they magnificent? Third grade, you're ready to go. Any friends and guests of the kindergartners, you're welcome to please come down and say hello to your children. Second grade and first grade, don't forget your Bibles, and you may also be dismissed. Congratulations, kindergartens. What a wonderful worship that you did.
Sing.